Dear friends, I welcome all of you please in today's electrical safety awareness program. Today's subject is why distribution box gets damaged and why there is more heat produced in the distribution box and ultimately damaging all the contents in the distribution box like MCCB, MCB, etc. Now please first look at this distribution box photo. Please look at the arrow showing the hot glow on the connection with female contact of a KitKat. Why this glow is there? Because no crimping is practiced here, even though technology is there, regulations are there, but no use, because the technology, regulations, IS codes are not being put into practice and the work is simply left to the laborers. This is my observation and physical observation. Now please see the condition of this rewirable fuses. Please see. And please see the condition of this, I think, MCB or like that. And please see the connections to it. How you expect that in such a badly unskilled work, how MCB are going to survive here? Here, in present condition of such type of works, only rewirable fuses seems to be the solution. Please see our skill of work, and kindly see what is the priority of today to attend safety. As per my opinion, today's priority is to put into application, into practice, the technology available, the rules, regulations available, and IS codes available. Now, I will again, please see. Now, please see the height of the distribution box. I will come to the regulation. And please see whether glands are provided to the cable entries. This is a very big source of entry to any vermin, rats, etc., and causing short circuits in the distribution box. Please see the entry of cable. Dear friends, topmost priority of today, this hour, is kindly to put the regulations, provisions available, IS code provisions available, into practice. We are not presently putting into practice the electrical engineering, the electrical science, and the rules, regulations available, and the course available. Again, I am insisting, kindly put all the regulations, IS codes, and electrical science available with you into practice. Only, I think I will not to use a bad word, but only discussions will not solve any problem. It is necessary to go to the site, stand behind the laborers, behind the workers, and get work done under the supervision of engineer. Here, I think there is no supervision of a responsible person, engineer, who can direct the working force. What are the effects of such bad working on the system, and further, how it leads to the electrocutions of human and animal. Again, I stress, please go to the site, please go behind the laborers, please go behind the workers. Only sitting in the air-conditioned office will not solve the problem. Can you excuse me for this my words? But because my ultimate aim is to save life, then only from my heart such words come out, can you take it in proper perspective? Now, again, I will stress one point. Why these MCB damages? Firstly, first mistake is locating the distribution transformer at load center. I think nobody bothers nowadays to find out what is the load center of a distribution transformer at site, and the decision is left to the workforce. Secondly, there is no equal distribution on all the three phases of the load. Then what happens? If there is much more load on one phase, it becomes overloaded, and one by one, the MCB starts damaging. Secondly, the distribution network is such in a bad condition, hanging wires, loose stage, then the wires collide with each other, causes numerous faults for which I think the MCB are not designed. Every breaker has a life of particular number of trippings, etc., etc. I think now present day need is to move behind the workers whatever they are doing and get it done as per the technology available, as per the regulations available, and as per the science of electricity. I do not blame anybody. Everybody is very expert, knowledge here. When a person acquires a degree of engineering, definitely he is an expert. He knows all the science, electrical science, etc., etc., etc. I do not blame, challenge their knowledge. But where the lacking is, there may be exception, but in most cases, the works are left to the workforce. And again, why? These MCB damages. Please see whether the space of the industrial block is sufficient to dissipate the heat developed in the atmosphere of such substandard works. Then, please see. Secondly, this is the door of the distribution box is open. Kindly. Secondly, now I will come to the cables. These cables, this is not the way of running the cables. Now I will read all the provisions in the regard, because I am advised only to talk relevantly regarding with reference to regulations only. Hence, I will go to the regulations. First, kindly read regulation number 79 of the CEA Technical Standards Regulation 2010. What are the provisions regarding to distribution box? LT distribution box. LT distribution box consists of breaker and fuse cutouts conforming to relevant IS shall be provided from where distribution feeder shall be taken out. Now, I am not disputing the quality, because the inspecting officers might have inspected it properly. The size of the box shall be suitable for accommodating Mueller case circuit breakers, MCCB, fuse cutouts, cable connections, bulb box, etc. Because there is so much damage, I have a doubt this size of the box is not suitable to meet the heat developed in this distribution box and dissipate into air. Thirdly, the distribution box shall be mounted at a height of 1.5 to 2 meters for the pole mounted distribution transformer, while the feeder pillar box can be installed on the ground. This is whether you see it is above 1.5 meters. Definitely, it may not be above this. You can see assess from the greenery there. And thirdly, regarding regulation number 80, the suitable high rupturing capacity cartridge fuses or molded case circuit breakers MCCB or miniature circuit breakers MCB or air switch shall be provided on low voltage side of the transformer of 100 kVA and above. I do not know whether it is transformer is above 100 kVA and below, but looking to the all the things in the box, this regulation is not complied with. Now I will go to regulation number 82, LT cables. I will only read the third. The cable shall be properly clamped to the support without damaging the insulation. Friends, there is no clamping. And what is the effect of clamping? All must be knowing that during coil, due to electromagnetic forces, the cable gets moved one side to another due to jerk. And if it is not clamped, the load comes on the crimped joints at transformer end and distribution end, and that also creates loose contact, ultimately leading the production of it. And again, I will read the 79.4. The capacity of lux for cables, connecting strip, but bars shall be as per requirement. Please see whether all the lux, crimping, etc. is as per requirement. Please see. I will beg pardon of all you my expert friends, please. Kindly look to this such a bad skilled work. How then these sophisticated protections are going to survive in the field? First need is of an engineer to be behind the worker and put all the regulations, IS codes into practice. Putting into practice is the need of this hour. Mala vatta, a knowledge without practical application is a zero knowledge. Kindly excuse me for my words. Again, I appeal to all of my technical friends, engineers, kindly find the today's need. Go to the root of the causes of all these things. Everybody is engineer. Engineer is a cream of the society in this every field. And that cream should be applied for reducing electrical accidents of man, human and animal, and avoiding electrical fires, breakdowns, failure of equipment, because this is a very big loss to the nation, ultimately reflecting in the tariff of electricity and then cutting our pockets. I think I have talked much. Kindly excuse me for such my language, which may not be suiting to all of you, please. But my intention is to save life of man, of human, animal, which is a precious, and every life has got right to be alive on this planet. Thank you, please. If there is any doubt, you can refer to me, and if I am mistaken, kindly guide me. Because you are having post degrees and very high qualification than me. I am a mistake, but I am mistaken. Kindly guide, please. I am ready to learn everything at this age also in the interest of avoiding accidents. Thank you. Myself, Ramdas Khandavale, retired Chief Engineer MSCB and National Safety Council member. Thank you. Kindly subscribe because I will not be in a position to post this video each and everybody. Kindly subscribe and please put all the technology available into practice. Thank you.